Good morning, fourth graders. I hope you guys have had a great week. Today I'm going to do a language video over your new concept of sit and set and how to use those words correctly. If you look on the board, I have it written out for you. Our first word we're going to look at is sit. Now, sit means to rest or to be seated. And so you would say, and some examples of that would be, Tim and I sit in the same row, all right? You could say, Tim is sitting two seats behind me. He sat there last month, or he has sat there all year. So here are the different forms you can use with sit. Sit, sitting, sat, have sat. And whenever you are using sit, you are talking about resting or being seated, all right? Now, the other word is set. Now, they are very similar, but they have different meanings. Set means to put or to place something. When you use the word set, you will always have an object that will follow it. I set the books on the table. Books is the object that is following set. And so some other forms of sat would be, Luke is setting my hat on the shelf. The object is hat there that Luke is setting. Yesterday, Ella set the baby in Grandpa's lap. Baby would be the object from that sentence. I have always, have set right here, I have always set my umbrella in the rack. Umbrella would be the object there. So remember, when you use the word set or one of its forms, set, setting, set, have set, you will always have an object that is following it. And look at set, it pretty much stays the same. You're just adding a suffix to it right here, but the rest of it, it's pretty much the same word. But sit changes from sit, sitting, sat, have sat. Remember, this means to rest or to be seated, and this means to put or to place something. Now, you have some exercises in your book that you're going to be doing today, and we are on page 237. Let's do the first couple together. You're going to fill in the blank with either sit or set. Look at the first one. It says, we will blank here until dinner time. Well, it's talking about to rest or to be seated, so we would use the word sit for number one. Number two, blank down please, Ashley. Okay, are you gonna say sit or set down please, Ashley? Sit, because you're talking again to rest or to be seated. Now look at number three. Would you please blank the box down over by the barrel? Now, this is where it's talking about to put or place something. And if you look closely, you will see the object that they are putting or placing, and you need to circle that object. So you would say, would you please set the box, that's the object, so circle that, down over by the barrel. And then let's look at number four. If you would blank here, you could see the performance better. Well, is it talking about to put or place something, or is it talking about to be seated? And if you're thinking to be seated, so you would say sit. If you would sit here, you could see the performance better. Well, that's pretty much your lesson for today. You have page 237 and 238. If you look over on 238, you're underlining either sit or set, and then you're circling the objects. Remember, only set has an object. Don't forget that. And then there's a look closely there, and then a little bit of a review there for remember D with punctuation and capitalization. I hope you guys are having a great week. In arithmetic today, you just had a review section, and then you'll have a review on Monday there for arithmetic. And then next week, we are gonna get into area and perimeter for arithmetic. I'm super excited about you guys learning how to do that. I hope you guys have a great weekend. Let me know if you have any questions.